Welcome back to MouthpieceSports.com's High School Buzz Session with Coach Jasper Strong of the Thorn Ridge Falcons, Coach Mike Bukowski of Montini, and Coach Virgil Guerin of Fenwick High School. We're all about high school topics, and the one we touched on briefly, but I want to get into more. We mentioned what players now expect. They expect potentially scholarship offers and playing time, but I want to turn that around and ask you, Coach Guerin, what do you guys expect of a player? When a young man walks through the doors of Fenwick High School that first time, whether he's going to play football, basketball, baseball, wrestle, or a young lady, what do you guys expect to see out of them?
I expect to see a full commitment. One way, shape, or form, a full commitment. We like to use the acronym WIN, what's important now. And in their high school career, you know, obviously, you know, there's certain pecking orders. And in their high school career, if they're involved with their social life before they are with football, let's say, for instance, that is a definite problem as far as we're concerned. So the only thing that you can ask for on the high school level as a coach is full-time commitment to play with a passion and to be dedicated to your teammates. You know, one thing when I was playing high school ball and college ball, I would always have a fear of letting down my teammates. And that's one thing that I look for in a kid. He's not afraid of failure, but what he is afraid of is letting down his teammates, which leads to better practice time, more of a commitment, so on and so forth. So when I see a kid walking through the doors at Fenwick that has that, that's special to me, and I want to make sure that kid sticks around for the varsity level.
Coach Strong, how rare is it to have that? Is that something you have to develop?
Well, you know, to piggyback on what Coach said is, you know, when you're talking about commitment and being responsible, I just had this conversation with one of my players the other day, is I want honesty from my players. And what I mean by that is, you know, I said one of his concerns is his grades. You know, we have schools coming in inquiring about him. And I said, you know, the major thing is they ask, you know, about your transcripts and where you are with your GPA. And I said, you know, you need to take care of your academics, which we all stress to all of our players. But the approach that I took was for him to look at himself and be honest. What is he doing outside of school after practice? Your grades are not slipping because of practice. Your grades are slipping because of what you're doing when you get home. Mm-hmm. Are you on the phone? Are you playing video games? Are you being social, you know, out with your friends outside of the house? So I want you to be honest with yourself, okay? And if you're being honest with yourself, you'll take care of your business first. Not to say that you can't be social, not to say that you can't do those other things where you have downtime, but at the same time, you have to be honest with yourself and take care of your business at home.
Coach Bukowski, there's an eighth grader watching this right now, and in 4 months he's walking through the doors at Montini. How do you get that mindset that Coach Jasper Strong and Coach Guerin were just talking about?
Well, I think to echo on Coach Guerin's comments there, you know, we always believe, and I know this is the way we were brought up, is, you know, you're always part of something bigger than yourself. You know, number one, the sport of wrestling, you know, and I stress this to the guys all the time, or football, whatever, done more for me than I could ever repay it. And I think I demand that same respect out of them. You're not bigger than the sport. I don't care who you are. I don't care if you're a full scholarship athlete going to a Big Ten school or whatever. You know, you could never possibly, be able to pay the debt back with that. That's number one. And again, you know, we want to improve on you as a person. And I think when you do that and those expectations come and you make that commitment in all the areas of your life, all this other stuff just starts to flow. You know, but young men, you know, and young ladies, that's a trouble spot in our society today. You know, sometimes as people of this generation, we kind of look at that and say, well, young people struggle with that. They don't really, if you give them an opportunity and you lay it out for them, you know, I've been very, very, very rewarded in terms of the people that I've had to deal with because they put it on the line and they follow those, you know, those things.
Well, your athletes have put it on the line to the tune of 6 state championships, and I'm not going to say that state championships are getting easier to win, but they're getting more frequent. And what I mean by that is IHSA expansion. I graduated high school in 1984. There were 5 classes in football, 32 teams in each class. Tough to get to the postseason. Now there's 8 classes in football. A lot of teams go, some with losing records. There's 4 state championships in basketball. There's going to be 3 in wrestling. Coach Guerin, does this water down what a state championship used to mean?
Well, I'm going to take 2 sides to this right now. First of all, I think
Coach Guerin's a lawyer too. Apparently.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. I'm being politically correct here. No, but in all honesty, I think it's great for the high school kids. The more championships that we have, the more success that they have, the better the better the self-esteem. I think it's an exciting time for the kids. So 8 state championships in football is great. Is it watered down? Of course it is. Anybody would tell you that. It used to be where you can be 8-1 in the Chicago Catholic League. There was one year where St. Lawrence was 8-1. I believe Mount Carmel was 9-0, and Lawrence didn't even go to the playoffs because of that. You know, of course it's watered down a little bit, but at the same time, I think that the format right now with the 8 classes and letting a lot more kids experience success, because when you win a state championship, it's easier, obviously, now to get into the playoffs, but when you win that state championship, nobody can take that away from you. I don't care if it's Division I or Division VIII, Class I or Class VIII, you're still a state championship, or you still won a state championship irregardless.
That year that Carmel went 9-0, they must have had some great receivers on that program. That might have been you, Coach Strong. You're a young man who is building a program at Thornridge, so I would assume the opportunity to get in and get there is something you welcome.
Yes, it is, but it is hard work. And, you know, actually we took a step back, in all honesty. Prior to me getting there, they made it to the quarterfinals. Mm-hmm. This past season, we went 1-8. So, you know, the young men adapting to a new system, offensively, defensively, they had to adapt to, and the coaches had to adapt to relaying that information and working together as a staff. But, you know, we're encouraged, and we're going to keep working at it and do the best we can.
Coach Bukowski, you have 6 state championships in wrestling, and last year, you know, you guys battled all the way downstate, and you lost to Sandberg, who's, what, 3-4 times the size of you guys now? So is 3 classes a good thing so you don't have to face Sandberg again?
You know, I really, it's a tough thing to answer that question, because I feel both ways on that. I think it's a great opportunity. You know, I kind of leave that. I guess there's people that are a lot smarter than me to figure all that out. You know, our attitude is just, yeah, exactly. Just tell us where to go. You know, I see merits with both of it. When we used to be a Class A school in a 2-class system, you know, our kids really wanted the chance to step up and prove themselves against the bigger schools. We wrestled them all during the regular season. You know, I used to tell our kids that all the time. We're a double-A school except for the last 3 weeks of the season. We wrestled a double-A schedule, but in our state tournament, we went to the single-A level. And now, you know, if they go to 3 classes, you know, the competition will be there. More kids will get an opportunity to participate in state tournaments and place and win it. So I think it's a good thing, you know, and things go in cycles. You know, we're very fortunate to have some strong years now, great kids, you know, but everything is cyclical, and, you know, good teams don't always stay good, and everybody changes. You know, I think that's what we all seen in high school sports.
Well, high school sports is more than just about winning championships. It's about the experience and becoming better young men and young women. Coach Guerin, what is the state of high school sports in general now? Are we in a good place right now with the IHSA in 2008?
I think we're in a great place. I really do. I say that candidly. Right now, we're having more kids participate in more sports than ever before. You know, my daughter is in 7th grade now, and I'll tell you, she plays sports year-round. I think it's just a great thing. She's looking forward to go to high school and be an IHSA member. Right now, I think the state of sports is just outstanding. I think that if we could get some of the kids to, you know, really enjoy it more so than putting that pressure on themselves to say, I need that Division I scholarship, I think that there's a big disconnect there. I really feel that kids should be enjoying their high school time. They should be enjoying their friends, their teammates, and there's so much of a drive. There's so much competition that's out there for all that important Division I scholarship that it kind of takes away from the enjoyment. I just wish all of the kids would really take the message that enjoy your high school career, because it's going to go by quickly. And when it does go by, if you don't have that Division I scholarship and you've been concentrating on that Division I scholarship for 4 years, that's a waste of time then. And I just really feel that way.
Can anybody say it better than that?
That's about it.
Well, on that note, gentlemen, thank you for your time. Coach Strong, continued success at Thornridge. I hope you have 6 state championships like Coach Bukowski does. Took him 22 years to get there, but Coach, thank you for your time, and Coach Guerin, thank you as well.
Thank you.
More engaging high school topics coming up on future episodes of The Buzz Session here on MouthpieceSports.com. Thanks for watching.